So you've probably been watching, like everybody else, curling at the Olympics and wondering, what is going on with that sport? That's amazing. Let's tell you three things that you need to know. You need to know, number one, every curler has two different types of shoes on. On one shoe, they've got a normal sole. On the other shoe, they've got Teflon on the bottom so that they can slide very, very easily. Second thing you need to know, ice is a crystal. And so every water molecule within the ice wants to know exactly where its neighbors are. However, at the transition between the ice, the solid ice, and the air above it, now those, that couple of layers of water crystals don't have a neighbors above. And so then they need to have a transition point. And what ice does then is it actually forms a little liquid barrier in between the air and the solid ice in the bottom. In curling, they take advantage of that. What they do is they will actually strip away, they will have brooms, and they will strip away the top layer of that water temporarily. And what that does is that exposes the next layers down of the solid ice, which then quickly need to form a buffer layer of the water above them. And then that original water can flow back on top. For a short period of time, you've got a thicker layer of water, which means that it's more slippery and it has less friction than it did before. What that means is that now the stone is able to travel even farther by sweeping in front of it and clearing the ice. Very quickly after that, though, the ice will then refreeze, and so then you have just that original top layer of liquid above. Third thing you need to know, you can actually change the directions of the stone by sweeping strategically. For instance, if you only sweep on the left-hand side of the stone that's trying to go around, the stone can actually curve and move exactly where you want it to go. Next time, as you're watching curling, pay attention to these three things. Enjoy.